Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on a Redis database. So till last lecture we have seen about how you can set a very simple string, how you can retrieve those string, how you can make some key to expire after certain interval of time in terms of second. In this lecture we are going to see about how you can use those functionality from the higher level programming language, and for our case we are going to select the Python programming language. So let's start that how we can install this Python client for the Redis, and how we can fire the very simple command for the getting and setting the simple key value pair kind of storage in a Redis database. So Python is providing the pip installer. This is one of the very easiest way to install the Python packages on a Ubuntu machine and even on a Windows also. So Python is providing this pip install Redis. I have already installed, so that's why it is saying that requirement is already satisfied. If you haven't installed, it will just install this Redis client library for the Python on your Ubuntu machine. For me it was already installed, that's why it is telling that it is already satisfied. So let's just import this Redis in a Python and let's connect Redis database from this Python. So we require to import this Redis first. Okay, we have successfully imported this Redis import statement. Now in Redis we have a object like a Redis on the top of Redis, where we can provide a lot of arguments like where the Redis database exists. In our case it is in a local host, so no need to require to provide any kind of arguments. Suppose it is running on some different port apart from the default port, you can give as an argument, but in this case no argument is required, and it will create the Redis object for us. Let's assign it to somewhere kind of R, and we will apply the operation on a top of R reference afterwards. So it has successfully connected this Redis from Python to the Redis database. Now suppose we want to set a string like we have a set command. Like foo is equal to bar. So we have a set function. Okay, it has given us true, that means it has successfully set this foo is equal to bar. Now let's get this same one with get functionality on the top of R. So we'll supply the key value. Okay, it has given us the bar stuff. Now in the last lecture we have seen about the expire and TTL, time to leave kind of functionality. Let's see how expire will work. So let's put expire for 20 second around, and so okay, sorry, actually we need to supply the key. So this will tell us that after 20 second this foo key will expire, and the same we can check with r dot get foo. Okay, still it is written because 20 second is not over, but you can check with TTL and time to leave, that how many seconds are still left. Okay, it has expired, that's why it has not given any kind of output. Okay, it has not given output, that's why it has expired. Let's try to do it one more time, like with 30 second. Okay, now let's get it. Okay, we need to set it first because it has already expired. So we have successfully set it. Let's get it. Okay, we have successfully get also foo is equal to bar. Now let's put the expire functionality on the top of foo key. Okay, for 30 seconds. Now let's get it. We have successfully retrieved this bar. Now let's keep checking this TTL. Okay, 22 seconds left. 20 seconds left. Let's just retrieve it. Okay, still here it has successfully retrieved us. Only 9 second left, so after 30 second it will just expire. Okay, it has expired. Okay, it want to give result for the foo key. So that is how we can connect the Redis database from the Python programming language. In a future lecture we will see much more data structure like a list set and a sorted set, hash map in a Redis database. So that's it for this lecture, friends. I hope you enjoy listening this video, and if you haven't understood anything, please write a comment below in the description. And if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please do subscribe and support my channel.